I'm standing in front of the latest generation of the Gamma Knife Esprit in this part of the world. It is a machine which is of extremely high precision to treat patients with very focused radiation. This device has a background of evolution by a neurosurgeon who had designed the concept of stereotactic surgery. It initially started with the Lexel frame, and the name goes by the person who invented that device, which is a very precise technique of reaching targets in the brain for very precise operations. This evolved into this device, which is also based on stereotaxy, which is using XYZ coordinates to reach with great precision radiation beams where it is required. This precision is at the level of 0.2 millimeters, which is far more than any other device which is delivering radiosurgery. This is a device which has been invented by a neurosurgeon and is essentially a neurosurgical tool. And it is very important to realize that, because we use this as a part of our armamentarium. So whether we are operating or we are doing this particular treatment, the whole idea is to achieve a cure in a lot of diseases in the brain. And it is a balance of these two procedures where we can achieve this goal. Sometimes we use this alone as a primary and only treatment. A lot of times we treat it as a part of the whole treatment, which is surgery followed by radiosurgery. So we use this device for a lot of benign tumors, and more for secondaries in the brain. It is an extremely precise device for secondaries in the brain, and we can treat multiple deposits in the brain, and more it becomes a very important strategy for treating secondaries in the brain. One of the main goals of neurosurgery is to try to cure with the utmost safety. When we combine these two parameters, it becomes a conflict sometimes, because the more we try to remove the disease, the more we are making it unsafe. So this new device is something which we use to balance and achieve, and yet achieve a cure. The balance is by trying to remove surgically as much as possible, and where we feel that the risk is very high, we would treat the rest of the treatment by this device. Adjoining it, that area, for example, the nerves related to the eyes, which are very sensitive to the radiation. So the goal of surgery then is to try to create a situation where these sensitive structures are as far away from the residual disease, and also the volume of the disease is reduced to the very minimum.